Today, the 20th of June 2020, is the shortest day of the year. It is also the longest day of the year. In the southern hemisphere, today is the winter solstice, when the sun will be above the horizon for the least amount of time of any day this year. In the northern hemisphere, it is the opposite, the summer solstice, where, you guessed it, the sun will be above the horizon for the most amount of time any day this year. We are going to look into how this happens and things you can look out for through the year as evidence. We are starting at the Murchison Widefield Array, a radio telescope on Aboriginal Wajarri land in outback Western Australia. The day this video comes out, the 20th of June, just before sunrise. I'd like you to take a guess as to what direction you expect the sun to rise, set, and where it will be at midday. I'll take a guess myself. I think the sun will rise due east, set due west, and at midday will be directly above me at a point known as the zenith. Pause this video here and write it down. Don't worry if you get it wildly wrong. Making mistakes is the fastest way to learn. Now, time to see if we got this right. As the sun rises to the east, except that's not really the east, that's more like east-northeast. To be specific, from the town of Murchison on the 20th of June 2020, the sun will rise 64 degrees east-northeast at 7:01 a.m. Let's keep a record of that. We will use that information later. If we fast forward to midday, we can see how far up in the sky the sun has risen when the sun is directly over north. How high off the horizon is that? It's certainly not directly above us, as I guess, which would be at around 90 degrees from the horizon. It's not even half that. Its altitude above the horizon here is 40 degrees. Best to record that too. So I wonder what the sunset will be like. Let's go have a look. Sunset on the 20th of June 2020 at the Murchison Widefield Array will occur at 5:28 p.m. That's an early sunset. Just like sunrise, the sunset isn't where you might have expected it, or at least not where I was expecting it. It's 296 degrees west-northwest instead of the expected due west. So I guess the general knowledge of the sun rises in the east, sets in the west, and reaches its highest point at midday is more estimate than precise fact. Good thing we tested this, or I would have kept thinking it was exact. Here is the full path the sun takes on the 20th of June 2020 in the Murchison. Okay, I know the seasons have some effect on this, even if it's just because I know that in summer, the sun is up before I am, and in winter, I'm up before the sun. Let's fast forward, because I don't want this video to go for 4,380 hours that would be required to get us to summer the normal way, in other words, 6 months. Again, what do you think is going to happen? Will the path be the same? Write down your guesses. I'm going to guess that the path will remain the same, but the sun will just move more slowly across the sky, as well as rising earlier and setting later. We have stopped nice and early in the morning of the 21st of December 2020. The sun rises much earlier than it did in winter at 5:16 a.m. And look how far away from the winter rising position it is. It's now rising 117 degrees east-southeast. That's a full 53 degrees difference. Looks like my guess was wrong. How did you go? I wonder if the path will lean towards the south or north at midday, and how high up it will be. Let's have a look. Whoa! The sun is almost directly above us, but not quite. The highest point in the sky the sun will reach on the 21st of December 2020, when viewing from the Murchison, is 87 degrees from the north horizon. So the path of the sun is still kind of leaning towards the north as it was in the winter. If we fast forward to sunset, we see, as you might have expected, The sun sets much later than it did in winter at 7:06 p.m. and again more to the south at 243 degrees west-southwest. Again, a full 53 degrees difference from the winter position. Here are the paths of the sun at both summer and winter solstices from the Murchison. If you want to measure these differences yourself, all you need to do is pick a spot you will observe from. It needs to be exactly the same spot each time you observe. At sunrise, sunset, and midday, take note of where the sun is. You can use a compass to determine the location of the sun as it rises and sets, and maybe a ruler held at arm's length for the midday measurement of the sun's height. Or you could take some photos. Be sure to keep a record of your measurements, as it will be some time before you do the next one, and you don't want to forget what you saw last time. You can, of course, do it more often than once in summer and once in winter. The sun's position on the sky will be slightly different every day. Now, not everyone lives in the Murchison. In fact, very, very few people live there. It's one of the least populated areas of land on the planet, which is why there are a bunch of radio telescopes built there. Depending on where you live, how close to the equator or poles you are, or which hemisphere you live in, will change what you observe. If you live on the equator, for instance in Indonesia, the path the sun follows across the sky at the June solstice looks like this, rising at 6:11 a.m. at 67 degrees north and setting at 6:18 p.m. During the December solstice, the path looks like a mirror image of the June path, if the mirror were the line from east to west passing through the zenith. The rise and set times are almost identical as well. This part of the Earth does not have the four seasons much of the world uses. If we travel to either of the poles, we shall go to Antarctica, but remember the Arctic Circle is the same, just 6 months out of sync. In June, when it's winter in the southern hemisphere, the sun does not appear above the horizon at all. And in summer, it's the opposite, where the sun is up constantly, but just appears to orbit the zenith through the day. The transition between summer and winter solstice sees days more like what the rest of the world is used to. Throughout human history, we have had many ways to explain these observations, but it was the invent of space flight that allowed us to finally see what was happening. Out here, we can see that the Earth is lit on the side facing the sun. On June 20, 2020, it looks like this. The light from the sun does not evenly cover the two hemispheres, lighting up the northern hemisphere much more than the southern. As the day marches forward, you can see the Earth is turning. The sun is that way, not directly in line with the equator, but you can work it out from what parts of the Earth are being lit. From a position on the equator, the sun is slightly to the north, which fits with the observation we saw in Indonesia. The South Pole in Antarctica is facing away from the sun and throughout the day will remain in darkness. The North Pole in the Arctic Circle is the exact opposite, receiving sunlight the whole day. If we compare the Murchison location to one mirrored over the equator, putting us in Jianning County in China, we see that Murchison goes into daylight much later than in Jianning and leaves the daylight earlier. If we fast forward to the September equinox, which is the date halfway between the June and December solstices, we see a day that is a perfect mirror image across the equator. For any pair of locations the same distance above and below the equator, the day is of the same length. This happens again in March, halfway between the December and June solstices. Moving to the December solstice, we can see that it's simply the reverse of the June one. Now the Murchison goes into daylight well before the Jianning County and leaves it later. These observations match with what we observe from the ground, observations that anyone can make as it requires no specialty equipment, just your eyes and your memory. Now the question becomes, why does the sunlight change its location across the Earth every 6 months. Have a guess and write it down. Again, don't worry if you get it wrong. Being wrong is an effective method of learning. To answer this question, we need to be able to see both the Sun and the Earth in the same shot. This is what we're going to look at so we can understand what's going on. You may be aware that the Earth orbits the Sun. That is, the gravitational pull from the Sun keeps the Earth traveling around it in an ellipse, a kind of squashed circle. From Earth, we were looking at the path the Sun traces out across our sky, but the Sun is not orbiting the Earth. It just looks like that to us because we're observing from the Earth. The Earth is in fact orbiting the Sun, following this path. If we stop here at the 20th of June 2020, we can see that the path of the Earth around the Sun does not line up with the Earth's equator. It's offset by about 23 degrees. We usually talk about the poles here rather than the equator, and the axis running through the poles. This axis is at 67 degrees offset from the orbit of the Earth, the same angle the Sun is observed to be at when looking from the equator at either solstice. At the June solstice, the northern hemisphere is pointing towards the Sun, and the southern hemisphere is pointing away from it. This means that more light is falling on the northern hemisphere, which is warming it up more than the southern hemisphere is being warmed, creating the distinction in seasons. As the year progresses, the Earth changes its location in its orbit around the Sun, but the direction the axis points remains the same. The north axis will always point towards the constellation of Ursa Minor, the Little Bear, and the south axis will always point towards Octans, the Octant. This means that at either equinox, the poles are pointing neither towards or away from the Sun, creating the mirror image of a day across the equator. About 3 months later, a solstice is reached, this one being the December solstice, where it is the southern hemisphere that is pointed more towards the Sun and is therefore receiving more light and warmth, creating our summer while the northern hemisphere experiences winter. Because the equator is always pointing at the Sun, it's always hot there. The traditional four seasons don't really apply. Due to local weather conditions combined with the seasons swapping hemispheres every 6 months, the regions within the tropics typically experience two seasons, wet and dry. The poles never really face the Sun properly, so they never receive much light. Even in midsummer, it's very cold at the poles. There are also only two seasons at the poles, light and dark. The mid-regions are where the four seasons make the most sense, but even there is a huge variety. Many indigenous cultures recognise a different number of seasons, such as the Noongar people from southwest Australia, whose traditional seasons count six: Birak, Bunuru, Jaran, Makuru, Jilba and Kambarang, and much better describe the unique local changes in weather than the four European seasons. Because the Earth does not complete one orbit of the Sun in exactly 365 days, the dates for the solstices and equinoxes will be different from one year to the next. However, the solstices will consistently be around about 3 weeks into June and December, with the equinoxes being halfway between those. While the dates will change from one year to the next, the explanation presented here will remain accurate.